Our Father and our God, your word in Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3 says, Thou will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusts in thee. Today we pray that our mind will be focused on you. Our mind will stay on you. Our minds will not stray away. We will not wander from the path of righteousness. We receive from you heavenly mindset. We receive from you the mindset of Jesus Christ. We reject ungodly mindset. We reject sinful mindset. We reject fleshy mindset. We reject carnal mindset. We receive the mindset of the Spirit. The Bible says that we have the mind of Christ, and Christ is the creator. So because we have his mind, we are creative. We are creative. Nothing is impossible for us. Because Christ is the Redeemer, we also are redeeming agents in the hand of God. Today, we shall redeem the hungry from hunger. Today, we shall redeem the naked from nakedness by clothing them. We receive the humble spirit of Jesus Christ. When you are humble, you never need to be humiliated. So as we embrace the humility of Christ, we will never, never be humiliated. Glory shall be our portion in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 2 and from verse 5, Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself, and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. So today, we embrace the meekness and the humility of Christ. We reject manifestation of ego. We reject pride in all of its forms. We reject arrogancy. We reject vanity of heart. In the name of Jesus, we embrace modesty. Nebuchadnezzar was proud in the book of Daniel. In Daniel chapter 4 verse 30, he said, Is not this the great Babylon I have built by my mighty power and for the glory of my majesty? And you became angry with him. He turned to an animal. You sent him into the forest for 7 seasons. Lord, for us, we say we have learned from these examples. Whatever we have accomplished came from you. We are receivers and not achievers. And so we bow to you in worship. We bow to you in adoration. We bow to you in praise and thanksgiving. Accept us. Accept our thanksgiving. Lord, we do not only bow to you. We do not only follow your instructions. We also follow the instructions of leaders that you have chosen for us. Leaders that you have chosen for us in the church. Leaders you have chosen for us in the home. We line up with your authority, and we pray that your authority will be the covering over our head. All through this week, our experiences shall be pleasant in the name of Jesus. This week, our Monday shall be memorable. Our Tuesday shall be triumphant. Our Wednesday shall be wealthy. Our Thursday shall be tranquil. Our Friday shall be far above principalities and powers. Our Saturday shall be serene in the name of Jesus. This week, the earth will yield its increase to us. Time, space, season will respect and cooperate with our destiny. Favor shall speak for us in the name of Jesus. Joseph said he saw the sun, the moon, and the 11 stars bow unto him. And so we decree that our enemies will bow before us. they will kiss the dust of our feet in the name of the Lord Jesus. Today, all our accumulated blessings, our accumulated breakthroughs, our accumulated success shall be miraculously released in the name of the Lord Jesus. We shall have undeniable peace. We shall sing songs of victory, and our songs of victory shall be loud and clear in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.